Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of The Zest Thing in the World, the sequel series in The Sims 4 to The Life of Thomas. This is episode number 13, and Rosie. Should be in bed. So should the boys, actually. I'm surprised they're not. Right, now we can actually do some bed assignment. So I'm going to have Abraham with the blue covered bed. Okay. No, I'm not. Sorry. But the blue covered bed is actually Lincoln's. Oh, it's AM. Not PM. What am I sending them to bed for? My mistake. In that case, I'll totally take back what I said about them needing to be asleep, and I'll have Abraham do his homework instead. Obviously, you want to go from a C student to an A student, and you need to do that, you need to study. And speaking of homework, we actually need Lincoln to be doing his as well. And no, guys, none of these boys are going to grow up to be president. However, oh, yeah, both parents has stuff they need to be doing for their job. What does Violet need to be doing? What's her daily task? Discuss outfits or fashion. Well, can you do that with your child? Interview Abraham. Would that count? Oh dear, what can the matter be, dear, dear, what can the matter be, oh dear, what can the matter be, Johnny so long at the fair. Right, they need to pay their bills, otherwise their lighting's gonna get cut off, and then I'm guessing Yeah, for comedy, he needs to write his jokes. A microphone wouldn't go amiss either, actually. You could practice it at home. As soon as this family has enough money to move into a bigger house, or move them into a bigger house. Sound good to any of you guys? I know Abe here will be as honest as he can be. And Lincoln, if you need the toilet, you know where to go. Oh, okay, your mum's on the toilet. Okay. Whoops-a-daisy then. Violet, what did you have to break the toilet for? Dear, oh dear. Well, we do need them to show some romance. Pardon me. And Abe sits on Rosie's bed reading. Okay. Compliment his outfit. Well, he could do with actually discussing. How is it that we have parents who don't know their children? Okay. No, hang on. Yeah, I thought so. Okay. Are any of these parents? She's feeling focused. Well, guys, I think this will be just as good a place as any to stop this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. There will be another one soon. Until then, bye. Hello, everyone. And welcome. To another episode of the Zest Thing in the World. Sims 4 series. We're now on episode 14. And yes, I am sorry that it's been so long. When did she finish daycare then? Right.31 days till age up. Of course, we know toddlers don't actually do much in the game. And is there a way to bring her home from daycare? You, young men, need to be doing your homework. Oh, okay, now she's home from daycare. Just how many hours does she go there for? This household really needs more money. She was at daycare until nearly 5 on a Monday morning. Johnny's got her. And he's put her in a high chair. She might not have wanted that. Right. She could do with something to eat, actually. Well, I think she wants to come out of a high chair. Well, we can't afford to pay the bills at the moment. Let's go to the mailbox. Okay. But of course, the kids can't pay the bills. And they need more money. She's asleep. Okay. The boys should be asleep too, though. They've got school in the morning. So let's see if we can get them to go to sleep. Well, with everyone in the sleep, everyone in the household asleep but Violet, I think it's time to send Violet to bed. Then we can. Oh crap. Yeah, I've just realized. Yeah, Violet should be going to work in 41 minutes, but the boys, they should be going to school. And they're still asleep. And Johnny's got work in 9 hours. And he hasn't done his daily tasks. He hasn't written any jokes or achieved level 2 in the violin skill, in guitar or violin. Well, if he's needing to do that. Which he can't do because they haven't got the money to pay their bills. Oh my. Violet, go to work. Yeah, boys, you're missing school. I couldn't press that need enough. But we need to get them out of bed. You haven't got time to be playful. You've got to go to school. And Violet, we need to get her out of bed because she's got to go to work. Does she want to get fired? Well, she can't because she's at work. Right. Let's see if we can get Johnny to come and take care of his daughter's needs. She needs potty training. Really? So let's get Rosie over to the potty. Oh, Abraham is grabbing his lunch from his backpack when he notices something red inside. It's a note shaped like a heart with the words, "You are cute," written on it, and nothing else. He thinks it might be the new girl who always seems to stare. Does he ask her or wait and see? Ooh. I told you to potty train the kid. The parenting skills aren't up to scratch, are they? What are you doing now, Johnny? Are you going to mop up? After that, you need to give your daughter a bath. See, she's not old enough to take care of herself yet. Well, actually, I was thinking you could take her to see her grandparents. Johnny. Because they are extended family after all. And she hasn't even met her grandfather yet. Or any of her aunts or uncle. I think I might have done that a little bit too hastily. What does she actually need? Amusement, that's what she needs. Okay. So Johnny could play with her. That should make her happy. She's angry now. Go here together. Because you actually came here to introduce her to the rest of the family. You might have carried her through the door, Johnny. Seriously? Oh, quick, 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 quick. Think you better take her home. Well, there won't be any need for that. I guess that's only going to work by inviting members of their household over. So, what we're going to do is we are. Going to going to call it here. For this episode, And I'll ask you to join me for the next one soon. Until then, bye bye. Hello, and welcome to another episode of the Zest Thing in the World Sims 4 series. This is episode number 15. And if I'm remembering rightly, she's exhausted. Okay, she wants to go to bed. Not surprised. So we're gonna read Rosie to sleep. Rose wants to come over and hang out with her grandson, and we're too late to reply. We can't leave Rosie there. Put Rosie to bed. Sure. And after that, still can't pay the bills, even though we got 638 simoleons to our name. Violet, why aren't you doing what I told you? Either putting Rosie to bed or reading her to sleep. Interview Lincoln. Well, the episode is called Finding Fun, but I don't think we're going to live up to that title here. After that, she can go to the toilet. And Lincoln ought to be asleep. And here he is taking out the rubbish like a stand-up guy. Now she needs to go to sleep. And even though he's energized, Lincoln should also be asleep because, again, he's got school in the morning. Hang on a minute, I thought the grades were up. For which boy? Abraham. Right. I personally don't think I'm gonna keep Rosie as a toddler for much longer. It would be interesting to see what she looks like as a child. Well, Abe, you know what to do. Lincoln's up and also needs a toilet. We only have one bathroom in the house. Well, there's a shower you need. There you go. Right, that is for one of the adults to do. Let's send the other son to the bathroom before he wets himself. And he can have a bubble bath. I thought I sent him to have a bath. You want something to eat? You need to give her food. Yeah, you don't want the social services to come and take her away, do you? She's gonna want something sugary. Yeah, but you need to put Rosie in the high chair first. So now, Violet. You need to put Rosie here. Work from home. Because that way, Violet won't, like, that way, Rosie won't need to go to daycare. And when Johnny's done, why don't you let us do what we need to do with that? She could do with a drink as well. And let's give her some AJ apple juice. So she needs amusement. Get her out of the chair. And this would be why I don't want Rosie to be a toddler anymore. No. That was good. But why ever is the kid angry? She needs sugar now. But I'll tell you what else she needs. She needs a bath, a bubble bath. Well, Johnny can clean all this up. Well, you know what to do then. Yeah, she's telling them she needs a bath. So if we can give Rosie a bubble bath. What do you mean you can't do that? Oh. Okay, let's see if Johnny will do this then. Give Rosie a bubble bath. Come on, guys, be parents. Your daughter needs a bath. One of you has to give it to her. She can't give it herself. Oh, for goodness sake, man. Right, there's only one thing for it. You can't do that at the moment. But you're leaving your daughter abandoned. Oh, cripes. After that, she can take a bath herself. But her daughter needs one. Okay. Now there's going to be, very little point in trying to get amused without a computer. So, let's see if we can get his grades up to an A. Violet. You need to give your daughter, Pete's sake, you need to give your daughter a bath. And when are they gonna let us use this to pay the bills? Right, pay bills. I guess they won't unless they've done it themselves, which means there is only one thing to do. It's time to age the kid up into a child. That way, she won't need to be so dependent on the parents. Right, with this cake, add birthday candles. Okay, we'll have Violet do this then. Add birthday candles. No, we're about to fix that. Candle help. Only mummy can help her with this. But they weren't taking enough care of her as a toddler. So that's kind of forced me. To do an early age up. We'll just ignore him. Oh, come on. The cake's gonna burn in a minute. Wow. Good news for her is her parents don't have to. Worry about that much care for her anymore. But one thing we do need to do is change her bed from that into another children's bed. So, and other things we don't need anymore. The high chair and the potty. Since we're only going to have enough space under this roof for two parents and three children. So now we can assign this bed to Rosie and have her come and sleep in it or cry it out. Okay. I think crying it out is what she really wanted to do, but you know, Rose is here. Well, she's come over a little too late, but we're still going to have to invite her in. Discuss outfit. Then she gets to meet her granddaughter when the time comes. She's angry about something. That anger's gonna kill her. We should try and calm her down. Which we can't. Okay. Well, that's bad news. But maybe we can cheer her up by telling her a knock-knock joke. You know, no, I've aged Rosie up. It might be nearly time to age Abe and Lincoln up. But they should all be properly asleep. Sleep. We need to wake him up first. Because he's already asleep. Oh, there's a monster under Rosie's bed. Oh, that problem. Oh, look who else is here. Right, there's no spoilage for choice, but. Rosie, why don't you try talking to the monster? Ask to spray the monster under the bed. Ask your mum to do And then you get to meet your grandmother as well, kid. You're lucky. So you want a friendly introduction. Well, this has certainly been an exciting episode. Okay, we're gonna call it here for this one. And the next one is coming soon. Until then, guys, thank you. Hello, and welcome to another episode. The Zest Thing in the World in The Sims 4. We're now up to episode 16. And now All three of the children are actually in the childhood stage, but I'm thinking soon of aging Abraham and Lincoln up to teenagers. And Rose is still in the house, apparently. Okay, she needs the toilet. Good thing for you now, Rosie, is that you're not a toddler anymore. You can just take yourself to the bathroom. And why is Rose still there? Okay, she's going now. But if she's lucky, she might get a visit from her granddaughter during the day, because a newly aged up kid doesn't have to go to school, but she does have to do her homework. Well, actually, she's got class in 7 hours. So, be better to have her prepared than unprepared. Sweet, isn't she? She needs another wash. Jeez, how often does she need to take baths? Has she got OCD or something? I've just seen her take a bath. And to that extent, so have you now, guys. Right, as soon as this household gets more money in, and enough of it, we need to move them into a bigger house. Okay, she's needing some sleep and she needs something to eat. So we'll have her get a quick meal of some cereal and then we'll put her back to bed. Because it's really too early in the morning for a child to be up and about. And then, because she was rudely awakened by a monster under her bed, she needs to go back there and get more sleep before school. Okay, the whole family's asleep now. That's good. Rosie is self-assured. Sims with this trait feel good about themselves and often experience extra confidence. I thought it was about time to apply that trait to a character in one of these shows. And here we are. I've done just that. Okay, the boys or the kids. Yeah, the kids all have school in about an hour. Yeah, Abraham's the only one who's up. So we need to get Rosie up and we need to get Lincoln up. Now. Post haste. Go and grab yourself a shower, kid. There you go. Just what I like to see. Well, you're feeling confident. Talk to your brother. Tell an unbelievable story. See what he thinks of it. No more children for a while for this household. In fact, they're in this actual house, they've had all the kids they can have. There's no space for another kid. So, and they're eating cake for breakfast. Wow. Right. Lincoln, go and have yourself a shower. And Violet can actually take paid time off. Does she need to do that? She can either go to work, which she can now do. She doesn't need to stay at home for any of her kids. They'll all be off to school. Violet, go to the toilet. Once you fix the damn thing or replaced it, then have yourself a bubble bath. Why is Abraham, or why are the kids not at school? Look, you kids, you naughty kids, ought to be at school. Look, you go to school, mister. Yes, I know. Rosie's the only one who's bothered to go. Oh, he's in the shower. Well, after that, you better get into school. Make friends. Make friends. Now all the kids have gone to school and make friends. So that just leaves Johnny at home, needing amusement. Well, but now he can play a game. And once he's done that, excellent. But all three kids are going to end up meeting the same child. Okay, guys, we'll call it here for this episode. I'll ask you to join me for the next one soon. Till then, bye. Hi, and welcome to another episode of the Zest Thing in the World Sims 4 series. We're now on episode number 17. And I go as far as to say that this will be the penultimate episode of series 3 of this. Because of how long it's taken me to actually return to the show again. And Violet has been promoted to consignment commentator. She will now make an additional 10 simoleons per hour for a grand total of 28 per hour. She has also received the following bonus: 370 simoleons. Nice. Barely better digital camera. Okay. So we'll. I don't know what Violet's gonna do to ease that tension, but she's lovelorn apparently. So that means the only thing she can do. Where's her husband? Of course, he's sleeping on the sofa. So we're gonna wake him up and we're gonna get romantic with him. Let's get flirty. And he's obviously had a bad day. Yeah. So what are we going to do to calm him down? Well, having a shower work? Yeah, take a cold shower. It's because if he gets too angry, he'll have a heart attack and die. We don't want that. Okie dokie. So hopefully that should calm him down. And well, you shouldn't really turn down a visit from your mum, but Violet needs a bath. If I can get her to come and take a bubble bath. Right. Your lounge is right by your bathroom. Why can't you go there? Oh, wait. Let's get her to stop watching telly first. Now let's see if she'll do that. What do you mean you can't go there? It's right here. For Pete's sake, do I need to get her to. Never mind. Well, maybe I can get her to go to the shower instead then. And he's still angry after a cold shower. What are we gonna do to calm him down? Yeah, I feel you, kid. Maybe a chat with your sister might calm you down. Apologize to your sister. What's he done to her? No. Rosie's going to bed. She's feeling confident. Well, actually, they should all be going to bed, but yeah, you know. Oh. Of course, you can't flirt with your sons or any of your kids, but your husband. Yes, come on. It should be asleep. That's right. And just for the record, this episode ends here. I'll ask you to join me for the season three finale soon. Until then, bye bye. Hi, and welcome to the series three finale of The Zest Thing in the World. This is also episode 18. And there's a monster under Abraham's bed. Under Lincoln's bed. Sorry, I've got the boys' names mixed up. Get your dad to do it, kid. Oh, your mum's up. Well, that's technically outside. Oh my goodness. The amount of energy this household has. Interview Rosie. Righty Ozies. Wow. All kids should be asleep right now because they have school in the morning, and the only one who is and dreaming of a political career is Rosie. Oh dear. Dear, oh dear, oh dear. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're hopefully gonna get the boys settled back into bed. Because quite obviously the only kid who's asleep is Rosie. No, Abraham, this is your bed. Oh, corrupt diddly app. A broken fridge. Anyway, we're gonna call it here for series three, guys. Series four will start sometime soon. Until then, thanks for watching.